I'd like to bring to the stage Jalila Ezzedi, artist and founder of Inspider.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Spiders and spider silk. There is where it all started for me. And here you see her in her full glory, the golden ovary of a spider. In a spider world, the females are much bigger and stronger. And the spider silk she produces has incredible properties, properties we for sure could use in our society. It's a better heat conductor than copper. It's biodegradable and biocompatible with the human body. And it's 10 times as strong as steel. But when we talk about as strong as steel, what are we talking about? In the case of spider silk, we talk about a combination of material properties. Here you see a comparison between Kevlar, a material which is used in bulletproof vests, and spider dragline silk. The dragline silk is the strongest thread, the skeleton of the web in which she builds the other threads. As you can see, Kevlar has a high breaking point, but a low extensibility, so less flexibility. Spider silk has both properties. It has a high breaking point and a lot of flexibility, which makes it a stronger material. Well, spider silk was imagined to use in bulletproof vests. But I thought, why even bother with a bulletproof vest? What if we could create bulletproof humans or bulletproof human skin? So I started working on bulletproof human skin, and I collaborated with a lot of organizations all over the world. And one of them was the Leiden University Medical Center, where I collaborated with the dermatology department, where we took leftover skin from plastic surgery and harvested the fibroblasts from the dermis and the keratinocytes from the epidermis, and let them grow together with two layers of synthetic spider silk in a full thickness in vitro skin model. The spider silk was developed and created into a matrix good enough to feed the cells, but also flexible enough to catch a .20 long rifle bullet. So I wanted to test this concept, and I took the bulletproof human skin with me and some other skins to the Dutch Forensic Institute, where I collaborated with the ballistic department, and we shot .20 long rifle bullets on the skin. The first skin you see here is a pig skin. A pig skin because a pig skin comes the closest to our own human skin. And as you can see, a .22 long rifle bullet goes straight through. The second skin is an in vitro human skin made of fibroblasts, keratinocytes, and all the skins were attached to ballistic gel to simulate the human muscle. And again, the bullet goes straight through. The third skin is a human in vitro skin enhanced with silk from the normal silk moth. And this last skin is the actual bulletproof human skin, existing of two layers synthetic spider silk and the human skin cells. And as you can see, the bullet gets wrapped in. The bullet doesn't penetrate the skin. What this means is that you aren't bulletproof. Your skin doesn't penetrate, but the impact of a bullet is much more. You keep a beautiful corpse. But it shows the incredible properties and uses we could have in society with synthetic spider silk. The problem with the synthetic spider silk is that the animals are territorial and cannibalistic. They try to harvest spider silk by milking golden orb weavers in the 18th century in France spider farms, but it doesn't work on commercial scale. So the solution with Inspider is to make use of genetically modified organisms, such as alfalfa, bacteria, silkworms, and goats. These goats carry the genes of the golden orb weaver in a genome and produce the spider silk protein in a milk, and through electrospinning we can obtain this material, which gives us a lot of opportunities because you can make use of an existing industry, the milk industry or the silk industry. The beauty of this material is also that you can adjust it for your application. So if you want to give it more toughness, then you add more beta sheets. If you want to give it more flexibility, then you add more beta spirals. This means that we no longer talk about tailor-made textiles, but the future is tailor-made fibers. Thank you.